Hey, it's Jason Lindsay with Hooked on Science on location at the National Science Teachers Association Conference in San Francisco. I want to show you and tell you a little bit about a unique company called Educational Innovations. They offer some hands-on products that you can use in your current curriculum. What Tammy has for me here is something called the Polydensity Bottle. What is that? And they can find this at teachersource.com, right?
Oh, absolutely. We carry this bottle in many other density demonstrations, uh-huh. But this one happens to be one of my favorite. And it's a bottle that actually teaches density to any grade level from kindergarten up through college, and it all depends on how the teacher adapts it.
And you have some ingredients here. I'm assuming, I know from using some of your products, that you have a really unique guide in there to take the teacher step by step through the experiment and all the ingredients here, okay? So show me how this experiment works.
Well, this is great because even a young child can tell you, just based on floating and sinking, which materials in here are more dense, less dense, float, sink. So if you ask any child, what is the least dense or the lightest material in here, they will usually say this liquid that's here, but in essence it's really the air. But then of course you have the white beads that are a little more dense, and then the blue beads that are a little more dense, and eventually you've got this liquid down here.
Okay. And these are different liquids. It's not just one liquid in there, right?
No, but it's kind of tricky because a lot of children will say that it's one liquid because it seems like it's clear, and they all identify it as being water.
Yeah. But you're going to shake it up and show us something unique, right?
Oh, absolutely. Yeah. Watch this. So if you give it a good shake, What happens is once the beads stop swirling, the blue beads migrate to the bottom of the bottle, the white beads migrate to the top, and then instead of having a clear-looking liquid, on either side, you have a relatively cloudy liquid in between the two. As you continue watching, the white beads begin to move downward, the blue beads begin to move upward, and then instead of being cloudy in the middle, you wind up with clear liquid on the bottom and on the top again.
Wow, so how many layers are here in reality?
Right now, of course, you have the air. And then you have this layer here, which is less dense than the white beads. And then you have the liquid that's in between, which is more dense than the white beads, but less dense than the blue. And then finally, the most dense material you have in there is the bottom liquid.
Wow, pretty awesome. Now, you can find this by going to our website, hookedonscience.org, and clicking on Educational Innovations, or feel free to go right to their website, teachersource.com.